Hello, my fellow subs and new channels that are checking out my channel right now. All Platforms Gamer here, and my Jack and Jack X Combat Racing playthrough continues by just showing the special episodes with the commentary and the other things in the reel in the secrets menu.
I guess the interesting thing for me about this scene is very little notice. Is one of my favorite things I did for the game actually was this sort of Naomi Campbell catwalk thing that I did for Rain. Doesn't really show up a lot, but I really enjoyed doing that. And I tried to keep that consistent with her attitude, or consistent throughout. I guess the other thing was important here was someone who shall remain nameless decided it would be funny to have UR-86 the robot pick up Daxter by the head, which involved a not at all trivial sort of inversion of the animation hierarchy. It was not easy to do, but I hope the payoff was okay. This is one of my favorites, actually. I like playing the Daxter. I think he's funny here, despite the torture he undergoes.
One of the new bits of technology we created for this game is the ability to stream textures off of objects in the background. And what this enabled us to do is do all these TV screens that you see here. What the animator would do is actually animate them as a separate scene, and then it would be applied to the objects in another scene, and then we would continue animating from there. Now, this scene was actually animated by Jason Martinson, and since Jason Martinson is no longer here, I thought I would attempt to channel Jason Martinson. I sat across from him for a while, so I think I have a pretty good grasp on his voice. Okay, one of the most interesting things about this scene is that line of Rain's, when she says, "Oh, joy, that Blitzfellow really gives me the creeps." Actually, that was supposed to be Kira saying, "Oh, joy," but the thing is, they both sound so much alike in that one particular moment that we just never really noticed, so we just went with it. So here we are looking at Sig inside the camera. Blitz is always surrounded by his cameras, and so wherever he goes, the cameras go with him. And so once he leaves, the cameras leave with him. Thank you, Jason. That was very informative. You're welcome. See you around sometime? Yeah, sure. So anyway, here comes Sig, who is the only one who is smart enough not to go to the crew meeting. We had actually talked about the fact that he was here after having received a care package from the crew posthumously, but then we just decided that at least one character was smart enough not to drink the poison. This is Josh again. This is actually one of my favorite scenes that I animated in the game, because GT Blitz and Hacker are both such dynamic characters, and they're butting heads all the time. It's kind of like immovable object meets unstoppable force. The other fun thing I had to do with the scene is I got to pull some images from the Jack archives. That one of Jack fending off Kira and Ashlyn, of course, was one I made up specifically for the scene. The other fun thing about using still images is that it means less for me to actually animate. Hey. This is one of my favorite bits with the shaky cam and Pecker and GT Blitz sort of fighting for the camera here. My wife says I make that face sometimes when I'm unhappy. And just lots of fun animation. And of course, you know, I have to throw an obscene gesture into the game at some point, so here it is.
This was a scene that was animated by Greg Griffith. Just so we made sure we made all the old Jack fans happy, we made sure Kira was definitely in the scenes a lot more, a few of the scenes, and we heard a lot of issues about people wanting Kira more into the story and into the game, so we did that. And so you get lots of that, and of course, Daddy's there as well. So when was the last time you ever saw a father-daughter fight in animation, trying to do something a little different? And also make sure that the Kira fans are all satisfied. One of the things about Kira that's interesting, all this whole story, when we started doing the Jack X story, basically, we wanted to kind of figure out a way to have the plot and all of these issues, these personal issues, actually interesting enough that they could also be resolved on the track. And so Kira wanting to race was just a perfect example, where she's always sort of helping Jack out, giving him tools and weapons and things. And for the first time, she's really pushing back and growing up and saying to her father that she wants to get out there with the boys and mix it up. So we knew that this was one of the smaller plots that could actually be resolved on the track. And a lot of the issues with Jack X was how do we make these plot points get resolved on the track, which was really challenging. But overall, we wanted to make sure that a genre that's traditionally light on story, like a racing genre, could actually for the first time have some emotional impact based on story and have a narrative that really makes you interested in racing, not just to race for the fun of it all, but to actually get out there and see what happens next.
Okay, what we have here is a scene with Jack and Rain Daxon here, and Jack's explaining the complications of the race. Of course, Rain isn't clearly understand, so Daxon comes in and explains it to her. And she looks kind of stupid here, and Daxon is just making her look like a fool. So soon, Cleaver arrives, and he adds more anxiety on top of what's going on here in the scene. But, of course, Jack and Dax are taking a stride, and they are totally cool with Cleaver. Cleaver does not affect them in any way whatsoever. As you can see here, Dax is making fun of Cleaver here, too. And so Cleaver is like, I'm going to get you guys, and that's the last thing I do as he walks on the screen. This scene here was a lot of fun to do. I got a chance to do a lot of different things with Daxter that I didn't normally get a chance to do, like having him flip around a wrench. I thought it was fun just to have an object that he could play around with and that sort of thing. Most of the time you just see him, you know, talking without anything in his hands, but with this scene I got a chance to do something different. Another thing to note is that I picked up animating the scene from Adam. He left midway through the scene, so I tried to match my animation to what he did earlier, and he did mostly the first part with Cleaver walking in and basically blocked out the rest of the scene.
Hi, this is Josh again. This is, of course, one of the big plot reveal moments in the game, where we learn that Crew isn't just having Jack race just for the heck of it, but in fact he's made a bet with Enzo. One of the interesting dynamics of the scene is, of course, as we find out at the end of the game, Rain has known all along what her father has been up to, but of course in this scene she's completely playing the innocent. So at the very beginning of the scene when Jax walks in, she's actually watching the hologram already. And the implication is that Jack has actually interrupted her, but the way that she plays it off is she's just like, oh, you know, I just happen to be going through my dad's things. So I tried to leave that fairly ambiguous. Now, this part of the end of the scene was actually one of my favorite bits that I worked on in the game, because there's a lot of good sort of interpersonal dialogue, and Jack giving one a fairly unusually long speech for Jack in the game. Usually Jack is a man of few words, but here he's giving a little soliloquy. And, you know, getting a little bit of contact between the two different characters. And Jack, you know, being the sap that he is, moves in to comfort Rain.
That should do it for now. That's it for part 3 for showing these special Ryoka cutscenes from The Secret. And time to move on.